Kirsten, we need you in that room right now. It's a homicide.
Alright, what do we have?
Well, apparently we have a male periphera age 26, which we found about 7:30 last night at the Sea Club. Cause of death is unknown, but we do believe that he may have taken in something poisonous while he was filter feeding, which is of course what sponges do. That's how they get their food.
Time to get started.
Nurse, the scissors.
So then Dr. Dorsett began cutting his way through the sponge's many cells, including the collar cells, the epileptical-like cells, the pore cells, which take in food and water that the sponge will later excrete through the ostium at the top of the sponge, along with other waste, and continued working his way down the sponge.
Nurse, sponge me!
Then, to check for any signs of strangulation, Dr. Dorsett checked the ambicaudies. Located between the two layers of a sponge, ambicaudies carry nutrients to other cells, aid in reproduction, produce chemicals that help make up the spiculus of the sponges. After more digging, Dr. Dorsett finally decided it was time to check for sexual assault. Most sponges reproduce sexually. Some sponges have separate sexes, but most sponges are hermaphrodites. A hermaphrodite is an animal that can produce both eggs and sperm. Hermaphrodites increase the likelihood of fertilization. Fertilization in sponges may be either external or internal. A few sponges have external fertilization that occurs outside the animal's body. Most sponges, however, have internal fertilization, in which eggs inside the animal's body are fertilized by sperm carried into the sponges with water.
Looks like this mystery was too much for even me to solve. Cause of death is unknown.
Doctor Dorsett, there's a problem. We need you in the medical room. It's a homicide.
Wrong side, son.
Ow!
Damn! Sponge!
Sponge me, nurse.
Did you just hand him the sponge?
You took back the camera.
Hey.
Hey, how are you?
Six, whatever he is.
Yes.
Devils.
Yes.